That map, which I will, I'll put it a little bit more like that so you can see, is the map of New Amsterdam in 1660, I think, is the date. And New Amsterdam, I don't know if you all know, is the original colony that was in the island of Manhattan before the English took over. So it was a Dutch colony. And my book is about that Dutch colony. Well, it takes place in that Dutch colony. And for people who are into maps, the amazing thing about it, I wish I could show it to you closer, but actually, I have a little bit of it in my book. There's a little bit of it here in black and white in the opening pages. It's got every house of every person that lived there. And there is a website where you can get this interactive map where you can scroll and it's New York and scroll and it's this map. And you can click on the houses and it'll tell you who lived there and when and what they did and everything about them. It's amazing. It's the most like amazing map ever. So for the map lovers. And my book is called The Diary of Asser Levy, First Jewish Citizen of New York. And it wanted to be a nonfiction at first, but it ended up being a historical fiction. And it's written through the eyes, like in a diary, the voice of Asser Levy through his diary entries, telling the story of the first group of 23 refugees. The first group of 23 Jewish refugees, well, the first group of Jewish refugees that arrived in America in 1654. And this is a story that very few people know about here. And the reason I decided to write it is because I'm from Brazil originally, and the story starts in Brazil. And these refugees came from Brazil. Another thing that a lot of people don't know, but the first Jewish New Yorkers came from Brazil. And originally, before Brazil, they had come from Amsterdam, and before Amsterdam, they were scattered throughout Europe because of the Inquisition. So this is like a story that has to do with Inquisition and Jews fleeing to different parts, fleeing to the New World. They went to a colony. They went to a Dutch colony in Brazil. That also there was a Dutch colony in northern Brazil, and then they escaped once the Portuguese took over again. And there were 16 ships carrying the Dutch residents and the Jews. There were a lot of Jews in that colony back to Europe, and one of those ships was diverted by a storm, was attacked by pirates, ended up not going where it intended to go, and landing eventually in New Amsterdam. Hear?
Yes.
Yeah, so this story is it's really neat, and it's almost like unbelievable, but a lot of stories about the time of the Inquisition and voyages to the New World are. And so I just wanted to say a few things about the book. So it's a fictionalized account, and I wanted to use the most historical truth that I could in it. But there are some parts that we don't know exactly what happened. So I kind of filled in the gaps, sort of guessing what as best as I could what would have happened. And the book is written for 10 to 15 year olds. And in the state of New York, the kids study in fourth and seventh grade, they study colonial history. So this book is really good fit for that age. It's also written in open dyslexic font, which supposedly helps dyslexic readers, although I don't know 100% if that's true, but it's meant to help them. And it combines historical fact with a compelling narrative to make the story interesting for kids. And it focuses on a little discussed area of Jewish persecution. So a lot of people just think that the first Jews arrived here in America in like the 1800s and the early 1900s, but they've been here since the 1650s. And it's really a more of a story about refugees, so it resonates a lot with what's happening now with the refugee and asylum seeker situation that's going on in this country and around the world now. So it's not really a book about Jews per se, it's a book about refugees and the hardships they encounter along the way. And the inside of the book is a combination of pages in diary form, but it also has like a lot of nonfiction elements. So it'll have a lot of sidebars where there are pictures and explanations of the historical facts that are occurring in that page. And as you can see here too, this is Peter Stuyvesant, who was the governor of New Amsterdam at the time when the Jewish refugees arrived. He's the foe from the video. He tried to expel them and send them back to Amsterdam or wherever they wanted to go. He did not want the Jews to stay in his colony. And the Jews and Asser Levy, together with some of the other Jews, actually went to court and fought for their religious rights and their citizen rights and the rights to stay in New Amsterdam and practice their religion, which is very unusual for that time. And here, also, like I travel to many countries to research this book, and so, but I wanted to put the places that you can visit that are in the story. So, and I have like the addresses so that you can find them. There's several in New York. There's the Brazil part, and then there's a place I think in Pennsylvania also. So these are more places in New York that you can see. Where some of the action happened. There's a timeline, and it's longer than what I have here, but I just want to show you, like, there's a timeline with all the historical facts and the sequence they happened in. And there's pictures of documents with explanations, and you know, that's the map on the wall up there. And you know, it's really interesting because for people who also like Manhattan or are interested. A lot of these places are still in Lower Manhattan. So you have like Wall Street is where there was the wall. I don't know if you here. I just put that picture there because that was the wall in New Amsterdam, which is where Wall Street is right now. And like right here, if you can see on that map, that's where that wall was. So that's where Wall Street is in Lower Manhattan today. So I have like several places written in that map that occur in the story. And also have glossary of words that kids may not know. And I have like the facts about Asser Levy because the story of Asser Levy, the main character, where he came from and how he got to Manhattan is a little bit controversial. So I go into like the facts that we know about him and I pose the question to the kids to sort of answer where they think he came from and to sort of uncover his mystery. But he's a well-known character in New York. There's Asser Levy Park, there's Asser Levy Pools in New York City. So this is like he's a well-known character there, not so much here in Texas, but in New York. And I also wanted to say that I've been giving a lot of talks on the internet about the book, like mainly to adults because adults are really interested in this subject. And this is a big talk I'm going to have in June, and it's with Dr. Noah Gelfand, who's a historian, who's an expert in New Netherlands. And this is for the New Amsterdam History Center, and it's going to be a nice event. But I've been talking to a lot of people who are interested in history and in this kind of sort of 1600s American history, Caribbean history. It's really interesting. I have a lot of slides with a lot of pictures, so I have a really cool presentation to give with this book. But yeah, my hope is that this book will interest kids and they'll learn something that they had no idea ever happened and open their eyes also to the American past that they don't know about, the Dutch colonial part.